Good morning, everyone. Welcome, welcome back. It's 2021, January. I hope you had a great, restful, relaxing, recharged winter break. It was well-deserved, well-earned. I hope you're ready to get back into it. We got some great woodshoppy stuff to do. If you did anything interesting, if you made anything, I want to hear about it. Please tell me, what did you do? Anything creative? Did you build anything? Did you make anything? I want to hear about it. So I hope you all are safe and healthy. We didn't go anywhere. We stayed home, being safe. I got a shelf refinished. I made this little 3-shelf a long time ago. It was kind of dirty sitting in the garage, so I sanded it up, cleaned up all the dirt and the finish, and put a new coat of polyurethane on the outside. I never explained to you how I built the bed frame, so that's going to be at the end of the video, but stay tuned for that. Because we're going to be home for one more week virtual, Woods One, we have another at-home assignment. We're going to be talking about doors this week, doors and door hardware. What's the deal with doors? A lot of good stuff related to doors, learning about our homes. So please check out the module Woods 1 for Doors Day 1. I am going to still be carving out CNC signs. So those of you who have turned it in before over the break or otherwise, we're going to carve those out. We're still going to be working on those. I want to finish up those signs and get them sanded and painted as well. So we will be working on that. Don't worry. If I'm ever in school and carving out signs, you can always use the code WoodShopCNC on the Google Meet to see the live feed of the CNC machine cutting, if you are interested. Woods 2, speaking of the CNC machine, you never actually got to do a CNC project because we went all virtual in the spring. When you were in Woods 1, you never got to do a CNC project. So we are gonna shift your gears a little bit. You've gotten a nice introduction to Onshape. We're gonna make a CNC project and we're just gonna brainstorm some ideas. So check the module there. We're gonna be designing a nice little 4x10 sign that we can carve in the CNC machine, get introduced to how that works before making your Onshape designed assignment. So check the module for day one of that assignment. Very exciting. The goal is to produce something that we're gonna take home. Woods 3 and 4, we're gonna begin drawing the parts to the step stool project. You have your brainstormed idea. We gotta draw out a plan with all the parts and scale sizes so we know they all fit together. But we need to have a roadmap to draw it in Onshape. So check the module for day one of the step stool actual planning part of the assignment. More information over there. I hope you're excited. I'm excited. We're gonna have some great stuff for these next 4 weeks of the marking period and end on a strong note. But how did I build the bed frame? I couldn't find something that I liked that you could even buy. And a lot of times when you buy this stuff, it's very expensive. So what am I trying to teach you? Build your own stuff. This whole project cost probably a little less than $200 in lumber, fasteners, and other things. It's all built with construction material, not the nicest wood, but when you paint it up look pretty good, it looks nice. So according to the plan that I drew, I made myself a little materials list. You can see in the bottom corner of the paper there. So these are all built with construction material, which is 2x4s, 2x6s, 2x10s. Most of the kind of stuff that you would use to frame out a house or a deck or something. They're all even though they say they're 2x4 or 2x6, they're actually a little bit smaller in dimension than that. So I needed a 2x10x8. I needed 6 of those. So I needed 6 boards 8 feet long that were 2x10s, 2 8-foot long 2x8s, 1 8-foot long 2x4, and 4 8-foot long 2x3s, and a 4x4 post, plus some 24-inch by 48-inch half inch plywood that was going to become the actual platform under the mattress. Plus I needed a box of screws. So I designed it in such a way that allowed me to have 2 sets of cubbies, one on one side, one on the other side, that was open all the way in. I could put shoes in there, I could put baskets of other stuff in there. The parts list that I created that was in the top left of that plan actually showed me how big each piece of the bed frame needed to be, which is important when planning a project, because if you have a lot of pieces that you're trying to keep track of, you need to cut everything to the right dimension and then assemble it. Otherwise, it can get really confusing. So you're better off organizing it all beforehand. Planning is very important. So I needed to cut 4 pieces that were 77 inches long out of the 2x10s. And I made them 77 inches long because a mattress is 60 inches by 80 inches. If I made those boards 80 inches and then I put the piece that was gonna be the footboard and the headboard, it'd be bigger. So I had to take the thickness off of the footboard and the headboard and make it 77. And then I made 2 pieces of 77 inch out of the 2x8. That's gonna be the back of the box. So the 2x10 is the top and the bottom and the 2x8 is the back. Cut those at 77 inches and then 2 pieces of 2x4 at 77 inches, which was gonna serve as sort of a shelf for the plywood in the middle. Then I cut 4 pieces out of the 2x4 that were 8 inches long. That was gonna be the little cubby support, the 2 parts that go into the box. Then I took the 4x4 post, which I had to buy an 8-foot long one, which is ridiculous, but so I had a ton of extra. But I just cut 6 pieces of that at 7 inches because I have these plastic bins that I keep under the bed with some like tools and things. And those are about 6 inches tall, so I made a 7-inch leg so they could slide under nicely. Spray painted those black because they look nice on the ground. So I needed two pieces that were gonna serve as the headboard and the footboard, kind of the frame. They're gonna be 60 inches long. So I had one cut out of the bigger piece cut out of the 2x10, and then I added a little 2x3 along the top edge of that to give it a little bit of a flare, a little bit of look. And then the plywood pieces, I bought the three pieces. I just cut them down to 24 to 41 and a half inches long each, and three of those. So there's a slight gap in there, but that's okay. Two pieces at 70 inches out of the 2x3 to support the plywood on each box. So once I had all the pieces cut out, I screwed the 2x10s to the 2x8s and made a little box on each side. Then I put the little 2x3 supports inside, screwed it all together. Before bringing it inside, it was all painted outside so we can get the gray color all matched up, same color as the headboard. I already had built a headboard previously that was on the old bed frame, and that's actually just out of 2x4s and plywood also, which wasn't really complicated to build. As you can see, it's just a piece of plywood, but with those thin pieces of wood nailed to the front, it kind of gives this look of like a panel, and has a 2x4 left and right post with a 2x4 along the top. I just used the 2x10 screwed to the headboard side of the boxes, and then the 2x10 on the footboard side of the boxes, screwed all that together. Got a little piece of wood screwed to the headboard and the footboard to leave half an inch gap for that middle support where I could drop the plywood in, put the legs on the bottom, held in with little L brackets, drop the plywood in on the top, and that's it. And then you unroll the mattress and let it inflate, and there you go, have a bed frame. I mean, platform beds are not that complicated. This one is a little bit more complicated because of the boxes on the side, but all in all, it took about a day and only a few tools to use, just a circular saw and a screw gun primarily is all you needed. I did use a power sander to clean it up nice for the paint, and I did use a planer to get some of the pieces flattened out a little bit, but it really isn't necessary. This whole thing was primarily built with a circular saw and a screw gun. So anyway, that's the process I wanted to share with you. If you have any questions about it, I'd be happy to answer. I know I went through that really fast, but yeah. So that was it, and I hope all of you are well. I hope your families are well, and I'll see everybody next time. Remember, more sound cares about you, I care about you. Be excellent to each other.